Ya Allah, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. We're starting MCQ questions in medicine. The first question. Patient had hypertension and he got intermittent claudication. Also, he got intermittent claudication or Berger disease. His hypertension should be treated by all of the following except. First, AC inhibitors.
Yes.
True. Diuretic.
True.
True. Arabs.
True.
True. Calcium channel blocker.
True.
Beta blocker.
No.
False. Because beta blocker cause vasoconstriction in the legs and make Berger disease intermittent claudication worse. Therefore, you shouldn't give hypertensive patient with intermittent claudication or Berger disease beta blockers. Female patient, 77 year old, she got osteoporosis and hypertension. Her blood pressure was 180 over 100. She should be treated by which of the following drugs first? And it is preferable to start with which one of these drugs? Beta blocker? No. AC inhibitors? No. Arabs? No. Calcium channel blocker? No. Thiazide diuretic? Yes. Because thiazide diuretic causing hypercalcemia in the blood and she get benefit for her osteoporosis from the high calcium. You should know how to deal with each patient with hypertension differently. Okay? The third question. Patient got elective surgery under GA in his abdomen surgery. He was not hypertensive before surgery, during surgery, and after surgery in the recovery room. His blood pressure was 170 over 100. He been asked to look for the causes. The following are causes of hypertension after surgery, except pain can cause hypertension. Yes, true. Full bladder can cause hypertension after surgery. Yes, true. Hypoxia can cause hypertension. True. And hypothermia can cause hypertension. True. While hypoglycemia doesn't cause hypertension. Probably cause hypotension. Okay? And for treatment of this hypertension, if he got pain, you give sedation. If he got full bladder, you put a catheter. If he got hypothermia, you cover him. If he got hypoxia, you give him oxygen. If not responding, you start in treatment with the drug. The following question four, the following are recognized side effects of vancomycin. First, Redman syndrome. True. Severe chest pain and spasm syndrome. Yes, true. Hypotension. Anaphylactic shock. True. D, E, all of the above. All of the above is the right answer for this question. All these we mention are side effects of what? Vancomycin. The fifth MCQ, the following are considered an early complication of acute myocardial infarction. By this early complication mean complication occur after in 7 days after infarction, within 7 days. Call it early. Any complication after 7 days, call it late complication. The early complication include all the following, except which? Arrhythmia. Yes, true. Arrhythmia can be single extrasystole to ventricular fibrillation, having an infarction in the early few hours and the first three days usually. Cardiac rupture, yes. An infarcted area, and it might be ruptured. This embolization because of the bed rest Especially if he is liable for embolization, obese, he was on a drug, etc., can cause embolization. VSD, through papillary muscle dysfunction, through ventricular aneurysm, can occur early? No. This is false. Ventricular aneurysm occurs usually after 1 month of infarction. Okay? The following question six, the following considered to be a late complication of acute MI, ventricular aneurysm through Dressler syndrome, pericarditis with pericardial effusion, it occurs usually in the second week, not in the first week. Hand shoulder syndrome, true, none of the above, no, it is all of the above actually. And the E question is E, all of the above. The right answer, all of the above, is a late complication of acute myocardial infarction. Question 7. The following antiarrhythmic drug working on the ventricle only, except A, lignocaine, true, acting on the ventricle, phenytoin, true, flecainide, true, mixlitine, is it true, digoxin is not working on the ventricle, it works on an IV node, therefore all are right except E, digoxin is not working on the ventricle. And the drug, the antiarrhythmic that working on both atrium and the ventricle, they are rhythmodan, amiodarone, wabrocanamide, and conidine. While the antiarrhythmia working on the AV node are digoxin, beta blocker, verapamil, and adenosine. Question 8. The following arrhythmia considered to be specific for digoxin toxicity. A, SVT with a block, true, yes, true, specific for digoxin. Digoxin caused this specific arrhythmia for its toxicity. Bidirectional ventricular tachycardia, true. Alternative right and left bundle branch block, true. None of the above, no, it is all of the above actually specific for digoxin toxicity. Patient had acute MI. He was in the CCU, found to be hypertensive, 200 over 100. He didn't have hypertension prior to his infarction. A treatment of this hypertension in the CCU include all the following except painkiller, true, oxygen, true, oral beta blocker, true. If not responding, you give what? Yes, IV nitrate. All these is the right treatment of hypertension. Okay? Painkiller, oxygen, beta blocker, and if not responding, to give IV nitrate. All of the above, yes, true. All of the above are true.